Very good afternoon, class. So as you all know, we have already started with lesson number 6 of our secretarial practice, that is correspondence with members. And we are practicing the specimen letters. So moving forward with the topic, we are doing under which circumstances the secretary comes in contact and does correspondence with the members. So we are studying the specimen letters, out of which we have finished the first two letters, that is letter for issue of share certificate and letter for payment of dividend. In that we saw how a secretary issues a dividend warrant, and second, if it is electronic payment of dividend, how the members are notified or informed about it. Now today, class, will be seeing the third type of letter which is given in your textbook, that is letter for issue of bonus shares. Now class, again, before we move on to the topic, here are some questions for you. What are bonus shares? Do you all remember, class? This we have already studied in the third chapter. To whom are the bonus shares issued by the company? Are the bonus shares purchased or are they issued free of cost? What are the different modes of issue of shares by a company? So basically, class, you have to answer these questions to yourself. If you have any doubts, then listen to the next slide. In that, all the questions will be answered automatically. So we are starting with the third letter, letter for issue of bonus shares. Bonus shares are fully paid up shares given by a company as a gift out of its accumulated profits or reserves to existing equity shareholders in proportion of shares held by them. They are given free of cost. When bonus shares are issued, the equity shareholders are informed by sending the letter. This letter contains total number of shares held on the record date, total number of bonus shares issued, the depository participant ID number, the client ID number, the date of credit, etc. Total number of bonus shares issued are credited either to shareholders' demat account, or a share certificate is issued if the shares are in physical form. So I hope, class, all the questions which I had asked you all before this slide are clear now. So all the questions are covered in this particular paragraph. Now, what do you mean by a record date? As it was mentioned over here, total number of shares held on record date. So what do you mean by record date? It is the date which is fixed by the company to decide the shareholders who are eligible for receiving the bonus shares. The company considers the names of those shareholders whose name appear in its record as shareholder as on the record date. It is the cutoff date for determining the number of registered members who are eligible for corporate benefits like dividends and bonus shares. So basically, class, record date is the date which is fixed by the company to decide which shareholders will be eligible for receiving the bonus shares. And those whose name come on that particular date, they will be eligible, and that date is considered as the cutoff date. After this date, no shareholders will be considered for giving the bonus shares. It is as good as, maan lo, aapki first merit list lagti hai, second merit list lagti hai, third merit list lagti hai, once you apply in a particular college after your 10th or 12th result. And if you are willing to get admission in a specific college, you have to wait for the cutoff percentage, right? After a certain percentage, you won't get admission. So similarly is the record date. After a specified date which is given by the board of directors, this date, no other person will be considered apart from this date. Ye date pe jinke bhi naam aayenge, all those people will be eligible for getting the bonus shares. After this date, if your name comes, you won't get any bonus shares for that matter. So I hope the concept is clear what we are going to study. So moving forward with the format, what is the format of the letter? How the bonus shares are issued? So as you all know, class, the starting is the name of the company, Yash Industries Limited. The registered address of the company is given along with its CIN number, which is a 21-digit code. On the left side, you have the phone and the fax number. On the right side, you have the website and the email address of the company. After that, you write down the date. The date given here is 16th of October 2019. Then you give the reference number Y/MRB/5 for the year 1920. B stands for bonus shares. Now here the shareholder is Ms. Yukta Shroff. Her address is given over here. The subject mentioned is issue of bonus shares. Dear Madam, I am directed by the Board of Directors to inform you that in accordance with the resolution passed in the Extraordinary General Meeting of the company held on 14th October 2019, shareholders have unanimously approved the recommendation of the Board of Directors to issue bonus shares. Bonus shares are issued in the ratio of 1:1. That is, one additional equity share for every equity share held as on record date 13th October 2019. I hope, class, you paid attention when I was reading the introductory paragraph. Now, class, do you remember EOGM? EOGM is Extraordinary General Meeting. That is, this meeting is held in order to discuss only special purpose matters or urgent matters. This we have covered last year. This is a meeting of the shareholders. So shareholders basically conduct two meetings. One is the annual general meeting and the second is the extraordinary general meeting. So as you all know, class, this EOGM, in this a resolution was passed that there will be declaration of bonus shares. So Ms. Yukta is being informed by the secretary that in the EOGM, which was held on 14th October, the shareholders have unanimously decided that they have approved the recommendation of the Board of Directors to issue the bonus shares. And how the bonus shares are issued? It is issued in the ratio of 1:1. That means you will get one bonus extra equity share for every equity share held. So against one equity share which you're already holding, you will get another bonus equity share. The details of issue of bonus shares are as follows. Number of shares held on record date is 25. So Ms. Yukta is having 25 shares of the company. So 1:1. If you have one equity share, you will get one bonus share. So similarly, if you are having 25 equity shares of the company, you will get 25 bonus shares. So number of bonus shares issued or allotted is 25. The depository ID number and the client ID number is given over here. The DMAT account number is also specified, IN30010010116061. So this is the depository ID number and this is the client ID number. And it is given that we have already transferred the bonus share in the DMAT account. Date of credit to DMAT account is, it is already credited by 31st October 2019. So Ms. Yukta has been informed on 16th of October and the bonus shares will get credited by 31st October 2019. The company has complied with the provisions for the issue of bonus shares. The bonus shares issued will rank pari passu with the existing equity share. Class, remember the word pari passu? This we have already studied in sweat equity topic. So pari passu means equal weightage. The bonus shares will be having equal weightage as the original existing equity shares Ms. Yukta is holding. So thanking you, yours faithfully, Yash Industries Limited. Signed, Mr. S.R. Nayak and Company Secretary. So is that clear, class? This is the way you have to write the letters, see the language, understand the concept. it has to be to the point and precise. So basically, you have to pay attention to the columns of the tables which you are drawing. So all the three letters has got certain columns which are very easy to remember. So how many shares are held, already held? How many new bonus shares are issued? Then what will be that if in case it is electronic form, you have to remember the DPID and client ID. Then date of credit to DMAT account. So this is the way a secretary writes the letter in case of bonus shares if they are issued to the existing shareholders. So is the topic clear, class? So with this, we have finished three letters of this particular chapter. We are left out with one more letter that will be continuing tomorrow. Till then, I hope you all are practicing and studying. And as I told you all, please practice the letters 2 to 3 times in order to be thorough with the letter. You can score out of marks in this letter part. So you have to be very careful and very precise to the point while writing the letters. So keep practicing and keep studying, class. We'll meet in the next session tomorrow. Till then, take care. Thank you so much for listening to me.